Why did you sign the petition?
So the petition calls for a halt to the development of extremely large generative models like the GPT-5 that's in development. And this is an incredibly disruptive technology. We don't even really know what it will be capable of. But what we do know is most likely advanced reasoning capabilities similar to the human brain. So in a sense, this is just too disruptive, I think, for the current moment. There's no reason we should really be building it right now.
What's being proposed is a 6-month halt in order to establish a shared set of safety protocols. There are names from all around the world. How do you make a 6-month halt happen where all the stakeholders comply?
It's an uphill battle, certainly. I don't think even the creators of the letter are overly optimistic. It's a big coordination problem, but we're hopeful that all the parties around the world will see the benefit of this type of pause, which I don't think holds back technology more broadly.
You know, Caroline, Kevin is a participant in this industry. Last week we had VCs, academics, who all basically said the same. This is really hard to pull off. 6 months, get everyone to participate.
Can I be, Kevin, therefore, just dig in a little bit as to why you, a founder of DeepAI, are saying this? Because could I be led to believe that in some way OpenAI is a competitive threat to you?
Well, certainly they are a competitor. We have many competitors. I don't think it's because they're a competitive threat. And I think that this technology is so powerful, it's not going to matter who owns it or even which country it's built in. What matters most is that it's built at all. This is such an incredibly powerful technology that I've started calling it the nuclear weapons of software.
Okay, Kevin. I'm going to dial back from that a little bit because we've had academics like Emily Bender of University of Washington on saying, look, when you are using even the turn of phrase artificial intelligence, it just keeps doubling down on the hype. It keeps reinforcing our view that this is in some way a competitor to human thought, and that actually, look, this is a worry about disinformation, yes, but the overall power of large language models, it's basically, it makes sense to us because we make it intelligent. What do you say to that, to the stochastic parrot argument, for example?
I think they're rather hollow. I think these models are absolutely intelligent. They're very general. They have advanced reasoning capabilities. In many ways, they're already superhuman. And it won't be long before
they're just
superhuman at almost everything.
They're just predicting the next word we might use.
Mm-hmm. That's correct.
How is that superhuman? Like,
well, these models, they know more than any single human, and they can recall the information much quicker, and then they have very similar reasoning capabilities to a human.
Kevin, you're a signatory to the petition. We thank you for coming on, answering our questions. Many of those signatories did not. There is an argument, I'm going back to this. Mm-hmm. Is this sour grapes? Is this you collectively recognizing OpenAI as so far ahead that you need a 6-month period to catch up?
Oh, absolutely not. We're super impressed with what they've built. We're actually huge fans of them. We don't like view them as a threat particularly. We just think that this technology is way too disruptive for its own good in the present moment.
Well, quickly, I want to ask you, what good has come out of this in the last 5 days?
I think it's a great conversation starter. It's getting the world thinking in the right terms, because this is not just like creating a new social network. This is an incredibly disruptive new technology. I would almost liken the global issue, almost like climate change, and that we have like a tragedy of the commons where all of the leading AI labs know they're creating something dangerous, but none of them really want to stop it.